from the very beginning, it has tried to improve the quality of dairy products that the Oregon creameries produce.
There's research comparing milk quality among different states, and Oregon ranks right in the top among the dairy producing states. Probably in part because of the work that Floyd Bodiefeld did for many years in milk quality. You know, our farmers have a pretty good sense of how to produce really clean and good quality milk.
Well, there was a big push to increase the shelf life of fluid milk, and we used the OSU dairy plant as a laboratory for that. Dr. Elker and Dr. Sandeen were doing research on what sanitizers worked best, which ones didn't, publishing research. We were the laboratory where some of those studies were tried.
We've gone from the old cream can receiving on the back of the old wagon, wooden churns, to aluminum barrel churns, to state-of-the-art continuous churns where cream is pasteurized, crystallized in the silo, continuously flowed through a churn that makes wonderful high-quality butter, then into state-of-the-art packaging machines. The technology in the packaging hasn't changed through the years. It's all still in a lot of the same shapes and forms, but the quality of the product has increased tremendously. You can give a lot of credit back to ODI and the university and the wonderful dairy farmers in the state of Oregon and throughout the Northwest for producing outstanding quality milk. They do a phenomenal job.
More and more research shows that green grass means good quality milk. So just the fact that many of our cows are grazing, not all of them, but a larger percentage than, let's say, if we go south of the border here. And that means we have higher quality milk because there's more fatty acids that have been found to have anti-carcinogenic properties and so on.
1996, when the American Dairy Science Association meeting was in Corvallis, and I was interested in trying to demonstrate where the quality of Oregon dairy products and milk quality was with other states. First part of the information I needed was from USDA. They showed and reported that the lowest somatic cell count or white blood cell count in the raw milk supply of all the states in the U.S. was Oregon. And earlier we had worked with the legislature and the industry to make more stringent standards for the somatic cell or the body cell count in raw milk. So we had this competition with our neighbor, sometimes with Washington, sometimes with California, who could, in a simple leap, improve the quality of the milk at a faster pace, all for the good of the industry in each respective state. We have to say that the West was the leader in this advance of more aggressive quality standards.
The quality has dramatically increased. Today, the producer, farmer, delivers to the processing plant better milk with lower standard plate counts than what went out of the processing plant 30 years ago.
It could be construed that we would have a contentious relationship. After all, I'm a regulator. We're all working towards a mutual goal, and they have the attitude that the inspector can help you stay out of trouble. All you have to do is become part of the solution. We've had administrators in the past, from Ron McKay to Jim Black, who have all been strongly associated with the dairy industry. And it shows when FDA or USDA goes into our dairy processing plants, they are clearly heads and shoulders above many other of our neighboring states. And it's because, I think, of our relationship, a cooperative relationship, that they are willing to do whatever it takes to be the best, and then subsequently they wind up being the best.